So what are the key characteristics of the TCP protocol? Reliable connection setup and teardown. That means TCP clients and servers adhere to strict to sequence to establish and terminate the TCP session that included to reduce the risk of packet loss. Once a session has commenced and provided for orderly session termination. So it's the session setup and tear down is happens. So one of the key characteristics of the TCP by establishing and stick to sequence of establishing and terminate the TCP packets. The packet sequencing facilities, these segments are assigned unique sequence number and that are used to ensure that segments are passed in the correct order to the upper layer application. From one layer to the upper layer, like in one layer to upper layer, it arranges in a sequence number so that it is in a fashionly, in an ordered fashion, it will go up to that layer. So while you are traveling packets among between two nodes, it may be selecting different paths, but once receiving and once getting all packets at a, then only it is trying to forward in the fashionly order so that application layer can take as in a single file. It also does error checking and acknowledgements. So what is exactly the acknowledgement is, TCP uses an acknowledgement which you can see that in the pack whenever we are reviewing the packet header, that uses an acknowledgement system to ensure that both sides of TCP connection acknowledge the receipt of the segments to minimize the packet loss. So we are using more segment because the packet, the data which is a part of TCP layer, the transport layer, we generally called it as segment. That's what we are more saying, the segments. So whenever the TCP uses an acknowledgement system to ensure, that is only for to ensure that both sides of the TCP connection acknowledges the receipt of the segments to minimize the packet loss. What is the retransmission of lost segments? If a TCP fails to receive an acknowledgement from the other end of the connection, the segment is automatically retransmit that particular packet, a particular segment. TCP applies timers to each sent segment that are used to calculate retransmission. So that means it is adds in a timer and forwards that segment to the other end side when it is not, there is no confirmation within that time that finalized, the automatically retransmits the packet. What is segment integrity checking? The TCP applies a checksum to both the TCP header and the data of the TCP segment. So any modification of segments in transit results in the offending segment being discarded. So that is where TCP role is very much important than IP. So TCP applies a checksum for both the TCP header and data of these segments. So any modification during the transmission and that results an offending segment in the being discarded. Then flow control, TCP has the facilities for signaling a remote peer-to-peer or peer to ensure that a host on either end of the TCP connection is not even overwhelmed the data. The flow control is always functionality of the overall flow control is intended to provide a consistent communication flow across the network. The multiplexing connections is basically which the TCP uses sockets, source address, source port, destination address, destination port, all these kind of a sockets to uniquely distinguish a particular TCP connection among the multitude of the TCP connections open at a local cluster. Yesterday we told an example in such a way that so at a time there are number of workstations are trying to connect to only one server, and in the scenario of one public IP address and multiple private IP addresses, so it gives a unique numbering through source port address, source destination, source port, source address, destination port, destination address. In it will use a variety of sockets to uniquely distinguish of in a particular. Even the one system There are three web browsers you are using, different browsers or different apps you are using, where you are connecting to one machine, that could be also distinguished by TCP protocol itself. So that is where TCP role is very much important. So, but whenever you are looking about the ports, what is exactly port? Port is a logical connection place. Let's take an example of home, of your computer at home. So there is a main door which you always can enter and exit whenever you go out or whenever you are coming. So that is what main door for anybody. So if that is one application to come anybody access your application, that is what the main door. But for this application to stay in that home and for a healthy way and natural air, natural light, you may also have some windows. These windows also some kind of port as an for an application such as getting in a sunlight and wind and proper light and all. So that is where the same way when you have a system as a web server, you may be allowing website, your website through port 80. But in the database access, you may be also opening in a some 1523. Or for depending on this service which you are hosting, it is also having another dependency on other ports. So you have to open other ports also. Like you take in a home as an example, the server is also similar kind of example in such a way that your main door as in a main port for your application. That application required a lot of as we said in example, air, good air or good light, natural light, that all things can come through the other different ports. When you are hosting three or four different applications, those applications also have their main ports. That means your home is having main number of doors, like main door, so to enter into home. So that is where port is a logical connection to access a particular application in your system. On computer and telecommunication devices, a port is generally the specific place for being physically connected to some other device, or usually the socket and a plug of some kind. Typically, a personal computer is provided with one or more serial ports, printer port like a parallel port. The serial port supports frequency. These are the hardware ports. Similarly, when you are connecting logically, so that means a specific process to which you know, which an internet or other network message to be forwarded when it arrives or when it is receiving a message to you, that is TCP and the user datagram protocol, a port number would be used. This port number is like in a header 16-bit number, which we will see in the header, TCP header. So by default ports, if you look into that, if you are hosting HTTP server, that means web server, the default port 80. FTP, the two ports it would be using, 20 and 21. 21 is for connection establishment and 20 is for data transfer. So there are two ports are required. Please remember this, this is one of the good applications for firewalls where most of the people will take example because it uses two examples. You enable connectivity to port 21, but if you are not enabled port 20, your FTP connection won't be there. Generally, the people will write one role to access the port 21 and to receive and to send. But if they forgot to write for rule port number 20, then definitely that the data, that FTP application won't work. Then port telnet is port 23, DNS is 53, SMTP, mail transfer is 25. And like this, there are a number of ports are there, like 110, POP3, maybe when you are configuring the email server and all. The TCP, these are the port numbers. Port numbers are basically by default anything from 0 to 65,535. But the registered port numbers are in the range from 1024 through 49151. And there could be a dynamic port number, some like whenever you take an application browser, dynamically taking one of the port numbers. But well-known ports are port 0 to 124, maximum all server-side ports will consider in this. But however, it is not limited to these ports only to the server. Some people, when they are hosting a second web server, they will keep another port number 8080, so that instead of 80, so 8080 also can be used. That it's not like it is only limited to ports 0 to 224. So the dynamic port numbers are from in the highest range 491.512.65.535. The registered port numbers are majorly from 10242 491.51. So the well-known ports are as we told that ICANN. ICANN is Internet Corporation of Assigned Names and Numbers for use by application endpoints that communicate using the Internet Transmission Control Protocol or User Data Protocol. So these are the basic things with respect to TCP protocol.